Okay, says we're on air. Okay, we're not live yet. Okay, let's get really excited. I want to test the mics. Reggie, talk.
Test, test.
Keep talking.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me? Test, test. Freaky Friday. Full house. Keep talking.
Our prices have never been lower. Our prices have never been lower.
All right, I think we got good. Can you hear me well?
I can hear you.
Can you hear the sound, the
yep.
crowd?
Yeah. Are we live?
We are live, pal.
Brian Clark, Reggie Edwards, WCWO Outlaw Arena, Freaky Friday 2021. Start the night off big with the Gunslinger Championship match. JB, our resident fraternity brother. Nobody has been at his fraternity meetings yet, Brian, but they're a packed house and it's a party. The party doesn't end with the party never ends with this guy.
You know, I wouldn't know. I'm way too old to be going to frat parties.
I've just been told. I've just been told by him.
I mean, okay? Look, I can still get my drink on, but I can't do it like them young guys do it no more.
I'm ready for bed now. I can't.
Oh
even...
yeah, I'm way past my bedtime.
What time?
Already.
It's like it's like 10:45.
You know what time it is?
It's like 10:45. Oh God.
Yes.
It's Dalton time.
It is Gunslinger Championship time, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it is. For the Gunslinger Championship, we have JB taking on Dalton Davis. We've seen this building up over the last couple weeks.
We were supposed to have it last week, but Dalton Davis chose not to show up.
Right, he no-called, no-showed, yeah. Maybe he was at a different frat party.
He was at the party that Jordan James, Easy Cruz, and Tom Van Zandt were at.
Was he really?
He had to have been. What a coincidence that none of them were in action last
yeah.
week. But they were all supposed to be in action.
Huh.
Notice they're all champions, too. So the champions, they had their own party.
Yeah, they had an elite party, apparently. Yeah.
Can we say elite?
I can, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we can say elite. You
okay.
can't copyright a word like that.
Well, I don't know. Ohio State tried to copyright the.
Yeah, well, they're morons.
Yeah, that's true.
And I also want to say, look, Dalton Davis is an Ohio State fan. Let's go to Nikki
that explains
for the
that
announcements.
Right. Paddling commence. He is Jay Beav.
Are you serious? Dalton Davis already just getting it. Oh, my God. Talk about an Ohio State fan would do that, getting a cheap shot to start the match, going straight for the back of the neck, trying to just incapacitate JB from the very beginning. This is just disrespectful. Why is our Gunslinger champion acting like this? He should be carrying himself with pride and dignity.
Yes.
Instead of it's not even a hockey match.
Well, you came to a wrestling match and a hockey fight broke out.
Ah.
Going for the pin. Quick kick out. I forgot to hit the manual focus on the hard cam, so I'm going to have to run out there and do that in a minute.
Way to go.
Yeah, well, that happens.
Dalton Davis looking to end this match early, Brian. I almost got to pee. Looking to end this match early.
Yeah. Oh, Beav ducks under. Goes for the roll-up. No. Rolled out. Drop kick by Jay Beav.
Dalton Davis taking a hard fall to the outside ring area, Brian. He's reeling. He did not expect this to happen. He thought he was going to get that early cheap shot. It's not working out for him.
No, not at all. Dalton staying on top. I mean, we saw JB get quick little offense in there, but Dalton knew how to recover from that pretty quickly. As you can see with the, I guess, the back slam on the apron, the little back suplex style.
The hardest part of the ring.
Is it?
That's what they say.
I don't know. I've never heard anybody say that ever.
They say quite a bit. I don't know if that's true, but they say that it is.
Who say?
They. You know, the people.
The people say it.
You know, it's been
said. Oh, and a quick little splash by Dalton going for the pin. One, two, kick out. Still not enough to keep Beav out. The party still rolls on with that guy.
Where's the solo cuts at, huh?
Dalton Davis just shouting, just complete disrespect, just pressing down JB, trying to take his mind out of the match. He's trying to embarrass JB on every level.
Well, that's what Dalton's been known to do, you know, since this attitude change that we've seen over the past, what, 2-3 months? He's really out here to embarrass people more than he is just to win and compete. It's not enough to just win anymore for him.
He doesn't just want to win. He wants to make sure that his opponent has no pride whatsoever left.
Sorry, sometimes you may hear me calling out to the cameraman as well tonight. I'm wearing multiple hats.
We always
literally.
You are. Shout out to Pro Wrestling Tees for that awesome hat you're wearing.
Yes, yes.
Dalton Davis is just angry at this point that the match has gone on this long.
Yeah,
he wanted to end the match early within the first minute. He wasn't able to do that.
I'm just really surprised Dalton Davis could quote like he did and ask where the party at. Oh, Beav with the counter there. That might have set the attitude straight a little bit on Dalton Davis. And again, folks, this is for the Gunslinger Championship. It's known to kick off our shows. Now, not every match is a title match, but tonight is a title match.
No, it just involves the Gunslinger Champion, and that's why that title and that champion is always the first match of the show.
Yes.
Because the first match sets the tone for the rest of the show, and we want to make sure, or the management does, that it's the first match on the show is going to get the fans going, get the fans into it. And unfortunately, we have a champion who tries to take the easy way out to start every single match in Dalton Davis.
And there's Beav. He's hyping himself up. Trying to get his mojo.
He's going for the initiation there, Brian. That finishing maneuver of his, he's going for it. But Dalton Davis has him up. Oh!
Two count there. But you couldn't hear me because I had the mic pointed away.
It's a family show, Dalton. You can't say that.
He just did.
He shouldn't have said that.
Yeah, that is true. But it is Freaky Friday, so. Oh, he TKO, but the ref is out. Going for the pin. There's nobody to count. Referee Marshall,
Bryant,
knocked out.
He got just enough of Marshall to make a difference there. Didn't look like he got all of them, but he got enough to knock him out. Jay Beav is just putting him more to sleep right now. But look at Dalton Davis. Look back there. Dalton Davis, he's got the paddle.
Oh! Well, now he knows what it's like to go to a Catholic school. Going for the pin. One, two. That was a little fast. Three.
Oh, and Dalton Davis with the win.
Your Gunslinger champion, Dalton Davis.
Questionable way of winning the match, but I guess it doesn't matter how you win. It just matters that you win.
When you're somebody like Dalton Davis, it don't matter. Yeah, you're right. It doesn't matter how. As long as his bag weighs a little heavier, you know, at the end of the night than when he got here, or at least the same weight for in his case.
I don't even know what to say right now. That isn't the way that we wanted the show to start off at all. Hopefully, number two.
I mean, I wasn't picking favorites because I'm not supposed to, but.
I'm not saying yeah. I was picking favorites. I'm just saying we were hoping the match would end better. We were hoping the match would be a little bit more fair and balanced than that. If Dalton Davis was going to win, I'm not against it, but as the champion, he should win. With respect, instead of taking the easy way out, like I've said, and using a weapon to win the match. He doesn't need to do that.
I don't think he needed to. I think he just wanted to. You know? There's some people that, hey, they just want to see the world burn. I don't know. I can't do a good Michael Caine impression, so.
I can't either.
Michael Caine. Yeah, I don't. I can't do that.
Well, JB gathers himself and recovers and heads back to the head to the backstage area. Match number two coming up.
Well, this ain't match number two, but this is one of our.
Is he actually going to wrestle tonight? Is he here?
You know what? We can both place a dollar and we'd both lose. All right. who knows? I mean, but it is a casket match. We saw the challenge put out there.
Obviously, he hasn't cut his hair or beard since he's been gone.
Right.
I mean.
Yeah, well, he just looks like every director ever.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Jackson Morgan taking on Tom Van Zandt, territorial championship on the line in a casket match here tonight at Freaky Friday. That'll be interesting. And things just picked up.
Talk about a crowd favorite.
Or not.
Yeah, that was sarcasm.
Yeah. Says music good to play. Says music good to play.
More weak to get.
Yeah, so unfortunately right now you guys can't hear the crowd literally booing him worse than, like, the Jets fans at their quarterback on a weekly basis.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh, they don't boo him that bad.
Pretty damn bad.
It's close.
And let's talk about the decorations we're seeing here. You know, our props crew really went all out tonight.
I'm loving it. It's Freaky Friday. It's Halloween in two days.
It's got a little Halloween Havoc, old school Halloween Havoc feel.
Yes, I love it. Hopefully our main event.
Those giant pumpkin men are really creepy, though.
Hopefully our main event doesn't go off the air 30 seconds into the match, though.
Oh, hold on. There's somebody we haven't seen since he went on, like, a silent retreat or whatever weird stuff he was doing.
I asked Logan Myers earlier tonight how the retreat went, and if his head is back in game, you know what he said?
His head's right there?
He said, yep.
All right, well, he's not a man of many words.
He never has been.
Why say lot words when few words will do? Hey, I got it in there early tonight. Got it in there early. That's an Office reference. I'm sure you guys are probably used to those by now. And speaking of offices, let's go to Nikki's office.
He is the Naptown Nightmare, Juwan Thomas. His opponent is from Santa Clara, California. He is loud and proud, Logan Myers.
Juwan Thomas with the hammer lock on Logan Myers, and Logan Myers reversing it. This is going to be an interesting matchup, ladies and gentlemen, because Juwan Thomas, more of a powerhouse, in-your-face, just overpower you style wrestler. Logan Myers, more of a technical wrestler. Juwan is all power. Logan is all finesse. So it's going to be interesting to see how this goes, see if Logan is able to channel his more dominant power side, or if Juwan will, slow down and work a little bit, technical, more technical style. It's going to be interesting. Or if they could just clash. Juwan telling Logan, let's lock up. Grab hands. It looks like we could get a show of strength, a battle of wills here. Juwan Thomas with the early advantage in that. Logan stomping the ground, almost like Shawn Michaels, but trying to get himself back in this match. Look at the power from Juwan Thomas, but Logan Meyer is able to get out of that, reverse it. Logan saying, all right, you want to try that? I'll show you how it's done. Oh, and a beautiful kick up from Logan Myers. Look at that. Juwan Thomas standing tall, trying to show that he still belongs in the championship picture, but Logan Myers trying to do exactly the same thing. Who's going to have the upper hand? Who's going to get the win in this match? This could go either way. This match just signed moments before the bell of the start of the show, so both men at a little bit of a disadvantage, not knowing who they're going to wrestle going into tonight when the champions knew who they were going to wrestle days in advance, almost weeks in advance. But if anybody can work to that type of a disadvantage, it's Juwan Thomas and Logan Myers. Especially Logan Myers having this entire last week to relax and really get his head back into the game. Logan kicking out just in time. Juwan Thomas never one to embrace the fans and show them how much he likes them, because he doesn't like them. I don't know who likes people less, Juwan Thomas and the fans, or Charles Minor and Jim Halpert. Juwan Thomas, Juwan tried to get that late match advantage. Logan just elbowing out. And Logan is in command. He is in charge right now. Logan kicking up and over, avoiding the clothesline. Oh, and look at that. A little unconventional and orthodox, but doing what it needed to do for him. This match is picking up, and it's picking up fast. Logan Myers taking time to just breathe, but he shouldn't take too long, because Juwan Thomas will take advantage of any opening you give him in this match. He's a former Gunslinger champion. He's a former tag team champion, and he's trying to show that he can be a future territorial or outlaw champion. And this match could be the opening that he needs and the door that he needs. But Logan sizing him up. Oh, and a springboard cutter. Look at that. That could be it, guys. One, two. Juwan just kicking out. Barely got out of that, but Logan is in full control. He is driving the car, and he is going where he wants to go. Juwan Thomas evading that. Oh, and the Claymore. One, two, at Jordan. Oh, Logan kicking out. Juwan Thomas cannot believe that Logan Myers was able to kick out of that Claymore. But in his defense, Juwan didn't get enough of Logan to really knock him off with that move. It's going to take more than just the tip of your foot with the Claymore to knock off Logan Myers. Logan Myers with the roll up, small package, not really quite enough there. With the backslide, Logan trying to do any traditional wrestling roll up to win this match. Juwan with the pop up. Juwan's trying to choke him out. He's got him in it, he's got him in the chokehold. We don't see Juwan win by submission often, but that's what he's doing here. Logan's fading. Logan Myers is fading. He's going out. Oh, he might be out. He might be asleep. One. Two. That's it. That's it. Juwan Thomas has choked out Logan Myers.
Submission or knockout. Is Juwan Thomas.
Wow, look at that. Juwan Thomas standing tall. The crowd not loving that.
Fixing the camera stuff.
Juwan Thomas with the chokeout on Logan Myers, winning by submission, Brian.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen often. Juwan Thomas usually able to power through, but Logan Myers wasn't going to quit with the Claymore and just everything that Juwan threw at him. Juwan had to channel himself and really, really dig down deep, pull out some moves he doesn't normally do, win that match. Well, Brian, it's time for our second championship match. This one for the tag team championships, I believe.
Yes. And the Mafia against.
Which Mafia members is it, Brian? Which ones are they? Who's doing it? Who's defending the titles?
Well, I know two of them that aren't here. Apparently, they're scared to show up. They have been since the highlight reel got hot on their asses. And speaking of it, there they are, the highlight reel, former WCW, multiple-time WCWO tag team champions,
right,
both just competed in the Young Guns tournament against each other in one hell of a match.
Yes. Now, they have the clear-cut advantage because not only are they two-time tag team champions and going for reign number three in less than 365 days, by the way, they were supposed to have this match last week, and they didn't get it.
Right.
So they have the anger, the rage, and the aggression on their side. Now, that could also work to their disadvantage. If they let that take over, they could lose the match.
Yes.
Is he gonna actually wrestle twice tonight?
I think so.
Jordan James' music is playing right now.
The Mafia knew there was no getting out of this match this week. It had to take place, and two of the members aren't here.
Are you sure anybody in the Mafia is here, Brian?
I know Jordan's there.
The only people in the Mafia out there in the ring are the highlight reel, and they're not even in the Mafia anymore.
Yeah, they're not in the Mafia anymore, yeah. Yeah. Former Mafia members, yes.
Ever since the new Mafia took over, there's not been a Mafia.
No.
The only Mafia that shows up is the not Mafia.
Yeah, ever since that new Mafia took over, Highlight Reel and Dex been hot on them.
Did the Highlight Reel get them to think that this was Thursday when it's really Friday and they're showing up tomorrow? Is that what's going to happen?
I don't think the Highlight Reel wants them to not be here.
Did they change their clocks back ahead 3.5 hours so that they would be – so the time would be off?
Maybe they're on Central Time, I guess.
What I want to know is, how did the highlight reel sneak into Jordan James's office and change the time on his watch to make him think it was earlier than it is?
Jordan,
that's why he's late.
Exactly. He clearly doesn't have a watch.
Look at him wearing both belts.
Yes.
He's the tag team champions.
He is. And given that we didn't see Cruz or Mac walk out with him, it is a tag team match, I can only assume. Skullcrusher is helping defend it.
Okay, I like that. I like that. That's going to be fun.
Hey, you know what? Skullcrusher's come in clutch in the past and helping Jordan remain victorious and helping others in the Mafia remain victorious. Don't count that guy out.
I'm not counting him out. I'm just saying I would like to see this.
Yes. But, yeah, Jordan James walking out with both titles. Let's go to Nikki for the announcements.
Introducing first, they are from Indianapolis, Indiana. You know them as the Highlight Reel. Tonight, they are Sub-Zero and Scorpion. And they are here for Fatalities and the Tag Team titles. Give it up for the Highlight Reel. Their opponents are going to go by the Freebirds rule, and they are going to be defended this evening by Jordan James and Skullcrusher. And as a reminder, this is a street fight, and it is for the tag team titles.
So yeah, it is confirmed. Skullcrusher is Jordan James' partner in this street fight. Reggie has to go to the bathroom, apparently. Christy, I see your comment saying, let's come on, twins. You know what? I know I'm supposed to remain unbiased. I don't care. I don't like Jordan James. So I'm with you on that one. But yeah, we're waiting to get this one underway. And the Mafia missed with the kendo sticks, but the highlight reel caught him with a pair of super kicks. Oh, and right on Skullcrusher with the kendo. And where's Damon or Damien? I don't know which is which. One of them just disappeared. Oh, cracked him right over the back. And there you can see Skullcrusher writhing in pain. Jordan James down and out in the corner. What are they doing there? Are they're doing something. Are those handcuffs? It looks like they are handcuffing Jordan James. What a tactic by the highlight reel. I can only assume that is something they learned from their time in the Mafia. As they just go to town on Skullcrusher, Jordan can't do anything but watch. This is so wonderful. Cracked across the back. Oh, man, this is like Christmas for me. What are they setting him up for? Oh, well, he didn't go. A little too heavy for him, I guess. They're trying to work him a little bit more. Maybe they get him this time. Oh, a double, like, rock bottom. Jordan James frantically trying to get uncuffed. He don't have a key. He don't have a key. Going up high. Whoa, he got here. He got up there, high as the clouds, with the elbow drop. Now the other one's going up. Skullcrusher just laid out. Frog splash from the heavens. Going for the pin. 1, 2, 3. Quick work by the highlight reel. And new tag team.
A highlight reel.
Oh, man, that was fantastic. I love it. Yes, your new tag team champions, the highlight reel, making quick work of Skullcrusher. One hell of a plan these guys had to deal with Jordan James. Handcuffing him to the ropes, completely taking him out of the match. Rendering him absolutely useless and leaving him for his championship bout. He's a little fresher than he could have been for his championship bout later tonight with Dex Royal for the Outlaw title. There you see the highlight reel out there celebrating with their fans. We got a packed crowd tonight. Love to see that. Everybody coming out for the Freaky Friday Halloween show. A staple here at the Dub. They love it. Always one of our bigger shows, one of our more fun shows to attend. Never know who's going to pop up in battle royals or in matches. Here we see Jordan James still trying to get out. Let's just let the crowd, you can hear the crowd just yelling and making fun of Jordan. But up next, this match is next. Jackson Morgan looks to regain what was stolen from him, I say. I mean, look, Tom Van Zandt did technically win, but he still stole it, in my opinion. The territorial title from Jackson Morgan. Jackson's been chasing Tom Van Zandt. Tom, TVZ, like, disappeared for a while. Then randomly he pops back up after Jax really starts laying, taunting him, letting everybody know that he is looking for him. Tom Van Zandt not backing away from the challenge. Comes back and last week issued the challenge of the casket match, ladies and gentlemen, which was a surprise to me. So, yeah, we're just waiting for the next match to start here. Doing some cleanup, trying to get the casket ready for this match. You guys have any comments, questions, go ahead and send them in. We're going to open the phone lines here. I can check on all the comments here on Facebook. Oh, we got somebody entering the booth.
Is that over papers?
Oh, sorry, I had my mic off for a bit there. As we're getting the casket set up, yes, Christy, that is Bruce McGarr's big mouth that you hear in the background.
I'm so sorry you can hear that. We told him we can't control him. He just says what he wants. He's like Jordan James.
Yeah, except Jordan did not do what he wanted in that match.
Yeah, I know.
Not at all. I loved it.
I thought we weren't picking favorites.
You know what? We don't, but I'm not ever going to hide my distaste.
No one will.
For that Mars Hill loudmouth, Jordan James.
I feel like he would embrace that nickname.
Yes, making his way to the ring, actually just sitting in the corner now.
He killed a guy.
Who did?
Jackson Morgan.
Who'd he kill?
Did you watch Inside the Dub?
No.
That's why you don't know this. He killed a guy.
I don't have Paramount Plus.
Oh. Well, I mean, look, it was a very... how do you think we got these decorations? Very lucrative deal.
Yes. Well, we could go TV, right?
We can go to Peacock.
Actually.
And we're too good for Tubi.
Hey, guys, if you want to start, like, messaging and getting a kind of a modern-day write-in thing happening with Tubi TV.
Change.org.
Yes, because those are always
Let's do a
useful.
Petition.
Yes. But no, I wouldn't mind trying to get us on Tubi TV.
He made it! He made it, Brian. He's here. He's
yeah,
going to wrestle.
Unfortunately, he made it.
He's going to wrestle.
Is he?
It's the custody of Terry casket match.
Custody of Terry. The custody of Terry. Oh, and he met him right in the middle of the ring. Let's go to Nikki before this all breaks down.
Introducing first the challenger. He is everybody's favorite psychopath. He is Jackson Morgan. His opponent is your current territorial champion. He is from the bad streets. He is Tom Van Zandt. And as a reminder, the only way to win this match is to put your opponent in the casket and close the lid.
Well, so what's going to happen is this is the custody of Terry casket match.
Yes.
In 15 years, Terry's going to debut in the ring.
Terry's going to debut in
yes.
the ring?
Yes. Well, that's what happens. You have a custody of match, and then in 15 years, they become a tag team champion.
Exactly. Yes. Yes. So I was moving my mic. Yeah. I was going to have to talk to the cameraman.
Tom's going to make a miraculous return to the ring in 15 years, so he can have a tag team champion match, him and Terry. You know, like Ray and Dominic did.
Oh!
I wouldn't do that, Tom.
Look, I've seen plenty of horror movies to know you never slap the monster.
Well, in the horror movies, you don't try to get close to the killer and the monster.
Right, right.
You don't.
Right.
You run, but Tom is too bullheaded and stubborn to run away from anybody. You just look at that.
Oh!
Big boom!
Yeah, right to that not-so-pretty face of TVZ.
I love it.
Next, we'll see him out here with a face shield on. Looking like Joel Embiid.
Hey, we've been trying to get him to wear a face shield for a while. He won't do it.
Yeah.
His exact words
were... That's 2 weeks in a row somebody's used that mask against Jax.
When we tried to get Tom Van Zandt to wear a face shield, he said...
Oh!
He said the face shield
could...
Hold on.
You can't... No. He just got kicked square in the nuts.
Now he's getting him. Now he's biting him.
Yes. Yes.
Uh-oh. Look at the rage in the face of Jackson Morgan.
He wants to say he's sorry. Yeah, you're sorry you got caught, bro. What a chop in the corner there. Oh, yeah.
Put it back down.
This is what I was hoping I was filming in slow-mo. Oh!
Jackson Morgan can chop better than that, though. I've heard it.
He's calling for it, too.
He's made people cry with his chops.
Yes. Well, he makes people cry with his appearance.
This is true. It's terrifying.
Irish whip from the corner into the other corner. Jackson Morgan knew it was coming. Knocked Tom Van Zandt clean out.
Put that mask on him.
Yes, I agree. Put that mask on him.
Yeah, man, like I was saying, last time we tried to get Tom to wear a mask, he said the mask couldn't afford his face.
That don't even make sense.
I know. That's where the casket is. Okay.
Well, what does it mean? No one knows.
It's like a double rainbow.
Well, it's provocative.
It's like a double rainbow. No one knows what it means. But it means something.
As they work towards that casket. Now, Reggie, what are the rules for this casket match?
There are no rules in the casket match. The only rule is you have to put your opponent in the casket and close the lid. That's the only rule.
Well, the casket lid's open. Let's see if Tom Van Zandt can finish this and remain the territorial champion.
And somebody wrap that casket up nice and pretty for Tom Van Zandt. Or Jackson Morgan, but
you don't recognize what that casket looks like? Have you not watched Squid Games? Are you the only person in America that has not watched that?
I still don't know what it is.
It's on Netflix.
There's a lot of things on Netflix. Escape the Undertaker's on Netflix.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Was it?
Yes.
Did you do all of the...
I did.
Really?
Yeah, it takes like 45 minutes.
That's not bad. How long's the movie in general?
Like 45 minutes.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, this... Oh, and look at that. Just... Face first into the guardrail, getting up close and personal. Mama Stark's not liking that.
He's really seeing lights. Like I said, man, give credit to the props department for decorating here tonight. We really making it feel different. We got orange ropes.
Hey, we take Halloween seriously at the Dub, Brian.
We do, actually.
We love Halloween. It's like our Christmas.
Well, we take Christmas pretty seriously.
We do. We wrapped a cage last year.
Yes.
I know, because I had to unwrap the cage last year.
Oh, were you one of the minions doing that?
No, I was outside the ring and had to unwrap the cage. The show started a little late. Took a while. From Iowa, okay? Yeah. We're a little slow sometimes.
Sometimes.
Usually.
Also, don't forget, tomorrow night here at the Dub, depending on the weather, it'll either be in the parking lot across the street or inside the Dub, our Trunk or Treat event from 6 to 8. Dress up, bring the kids. Some of the wrestlers will be here passing out candy or passing out tricks. Who knows?
Yeah.
Maybe, I don't know. Maybe you can. You want one of your kids in a coffin. We can make that happen.
Apparently we have two now.
We do. That is a new coffin.
Tom Van Zandt tried to escape the building. He's had an upright. He's had enough. He doesn't want to have anything to do with this. It's like he said, he's come, Brian, Tom Van Zandt's come close to death twice.
Well, I think he was coming close to concessions.
Well, I mean, shout out to Juanita for some awesome concessions out there, though.
I'll be out there in a minute.
Tenderloins, hot dogs, awesome stuff.
I can't really see what's going on too well out there.
Well, they're both wearing black, and it doesn't help.
Right. As long as they don't knock over my camera, I'm good. All right, they're making their way back.
Tom Van Zandt isn't going to get out of this match that easy.
No, not at all. Just tosses him right back over. Right back into the field of play.
Just like the bag of
Game
scum
on.
That he is. Not that I'm biased, but he hasn't necessarily been the nicest to us.
No, he's not nice to anybody. Never has. He's never claimed to be.
That's true.
A little shot to the breadbasket by Tom Van Zandt trying to fight back here.
Jackson Morgan is reeling. If he's not careful, he's going to fall back first into that coffin. Don't fall back.
Go ahead and get that.
The crowd chanting for Jackson to get back in this match and get Tom in the casket.
Yeah, they are, but it looks, well, the lid's closed now. Well, back body drop right on top of the casket. surprised he didn't go all the way through it.
He's lucky he didn't. That would have been the finish. That would have been the end of the match if he fell into that.
You know what? Credit to Tommy Two Shoes, referee, who actually built this casket for us. He built a pretty sturdy casket.
He painted it the same. Well, he painted it the same color as Todd Van Zandt's heart.
Todd Van Zandt don't have a heart. That's why he was going to see the wizard.
It's dark.
Hold on. What's he doing? Oh, he's stealing chairs.
He just wants to sit. That's
yeah, well, that's better than the faces he's normally trying to steal from people.
Yeah. Gosh. He makes his pies are scary.
Yeah. Has he invited you over for a barbecue? He asked me, and I was like, no, dude.
He did. I'm good. I told him I checked my schedule.
I didn't even tell him that. I just replied back, new phone, who dis?
I asked what he was going to have, and he sent me a shrugging.
Oh, well, he just...
He sent me a shrugging emoji.
Just tossed the door in the ring. He's setting up for something pretty diabolical, it looks like.
Well, it's a good thing there's no rules in a casket match. Because anything goes, so you can use anything, not just the casket, to incapacitate your opponent. As much crap as we talk about Tom Van Zandt, he is a tough son of a gun, and it is going to take a lot to incapacitate him to the point where you can shut him inside of a casket. Especially considering how close he's come to being inside of those so many times, it's going to take a lot to get him inside of that casket.
Yes,
Jackson.
It is.
Jackson is going to have to really pull out all the stops.
And we see Jax setting this up, like setting up the doors. You know, which is something you probably become accustomed to watching independent wrestling.
Yeah.
Tables are expensive.
There's
somehow,
doors.
Somehow, there's an abundance of doors
everywhere.
Yes.
Where did they get all the doors?
No idea. Maybe from Monsters, Inc. Hey, that's a fitting little reference for tonight.
Did they use a lot of doors on that movie?
Have you not seen Monsters, Inc.?
I have not seen Monsters, Inc.
You have kids. I don't do. I've seen all
of them. I do. I have kids.
You're terrible parents.
Two of them are 5 months old. They don't watch movies. They like football and wrestling. They like football and wrestling. The other one, not a fan of movies. She gets mad
at me. As long as you don't let him watch a Tom Van Zandt match, I think you're good.
That's true. I will tell you, when I had the 5-month-old twins all day long, they were screaming a lot, so I gave them something to scream about. They watched WCW.
Well, Jack's got Tom up. Let's see what he's going to do with him. He's trying. Can he get in position?
Oh, no!
Oh,
right through the door. Tom Van Zandt is out, Brian. He is out.
And he put him through with force.
The lights are out, Brian. They're back
no,
up.
The camera went out.
Oh, okay. Thank God.
And I hit the wrong button.
I know. That terrifying picture of Tom Van Zandt showed back up.
All right. Well, I got to go fix the mobile cam.
I got this. Jackson Morgan, we have an obstructed view here, but Jackson Morgan he's got Tom Van Zandt up. He's rolling him out of the ring. He's got him. Shout out to Brian Clark, wearing all the hats, going out fixing mobile cam right now. Hope we get that back up and running before Tom gets shut in the casket. It is over, Tom Van Zandt.
The winner and new territorial champion, Jackson Morgan.
Jackson Morgan has dethroned Tom Van Zandt and become a two-time territorial champion. This man had this territorial championship stolen from him in June and July by Tom Van Zandt, and he has done everything he can to get that title back. He is
once again your winner and new territorial champion, Jackson Morgan.
We've seen him terrorize his way back to becoming territorial champion. It has not been an easy road for Jackson Morgan.
It has not, no.
The first defeating Dex Royal and then mutilating Tom Van Zandt.
I'm just letting Jackson finally enjoy this. finally got the territorial championship back. Freaky Friday has come up pretty spectacular, I'll be honest. Two new champions tonight.
It's freaky good.
Yeah. And let's not forget, second half of the show, we still have the Outlaw title on the line. Dex Royal defending his championship against former friend, partner. Well, hold on, what's going on here? Offering a handshake.
Uncharacteristic of Tom Van Zandt.
Yeah.
Very respectful.
Yeah.
And a classy move from Tom Van Zandt.
But yeah, territorial title, Outlaw Championship on the line, second half of the show. And also, WCWO ownership on the line tonight. Joey Owens, JKO, literally putting the business, the promotion on the line against Blake Wright.
I shudder to think of what next week could look like here at the Dub, Brian.
I agree. So, yeah, that's coming up second half. We'll be back in about 10, 15 minutes. So, yeah, just tune back in, guys. We're going to go to a little intermission. Let you guys go get your food, get your snacks, get your gummy worms, whatever you're going to eat tonight. I know I'm going to have a ton of gummy worms. So, yeah, we'll be back.
Are we on?
Yes.
All right. We're still live?
Yes.
We were live that whole time?
Yes.
Okay. All right, Brian Clark, we are back. Halloween Battle Royal in the ring right now. Is that T.S. Wiley looks different, Brian.
No, he don't. He just got a tan.
Wow.
He's just got a tan. That's it.
He got burned.
I definitely know that we can't play this song.
Yes, that's us.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, look, he's just tan.
Were you the one that posted the meme that said the Monster Mash is the same as Tribute by Tenacious D? They're both about a song, but it's not the song that the song's about.
No, I did not, but that is a great observation. Yes.
So nobody's actually seen or heard what the Monster Mash actually was.
No, it's just a song about the Monster Mash.
I don't like that camera angle. Oh wait, no, we're not on mobile cam.
Yes.
Bad camera.
See, this
angle.
Is why I control. Hold on, that's not Wiley.
Whoa, Brian Clark. That's Hidari.
It's not me either.
That was the best Halloween costume ever. I don't even know what to say right now. Man, Halloween, man.
And speaking of people dressed up, who is that dressed up as a referee down there? Hold on, we'll see. Oh, hold on.
Oh, my God.
Tom Van Zandt's back.
Wow.
Tom Van Zandt is back.
What is going on, Brian? Everybody looks different tonight.
He got small. I mean, hey, man.
Well, that.
They say as you get older, you get smaller. Well, he looks younger.
That's how big his pride is after winning
that. Is that a casket of youth?
Ooh. Well, that's how big his pride is after losing that title match.
Yes.
Yes.
Hey, look, he's just going to chill up there. Oh. Yeah, that's very TVZ.
Yep. Yep. That is
very TVZ. He just chilling out.
I am sold. Where did he find the Fountain of Youth?
It was in that casket.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yes.
Was that casted like Matt Hardy's
lake?
Yes. Yes. Okay. You know what? Since everybody's going to come out little by little, I'm just going to leave Nikki's mic on.
Since everybody's... Oh, never mind. It really is Dutch Boy. I thought we were... Okay. Yep. Well, this match
Dutch
went
Boy's
down...
Dutch Boy's not always in costume anyway.
This match went downhill fast. Nobody wants to see this man.
Oh!
Mikal Murphy has been eliminated!
Oh, T.S. T.S. Hidari and Dutch Boy are going
Our next entrance
ring.
Is Mac Sterling!
Hold on, what?
Really?
Hold on, he's here? Hold on, where was he earlier? Where was he earlier?
He was hiding from a street fight.
He thought
the fight was on his street at home.
No!
Hidari has been eliminated!
It was a Nightmare on Elm Street fight.
He doesn't know that, though.
Well, he didn't.
He doesn't have internet to watch inside the dub, so he didn't know. He just heard street fight, and he went out to the street.
They have internet in Martinsville.
Not fast internet.
It's still
dial-up. It's like the internet we have in Iowa.
Hidari is out.
DSL.
He's already out.
No, that's white.
Hey, look at these. Yeah, they're picking on Tom Van Zandt here.
Tom Van Zandt just going to sit here and take that? Oh!
Tilt the camera.
No. He's going for a head scissors takedown.
Dutch Boy just playing with little Tom Van Zandt. Hold on, what's happening?
Oh, this could be bad. This could be bad. Are we going to see it? Is Dutch Boy going to get eliminated by Tom Van Zandt? This could be the best thing Tom Van Zandt does all night.
Well, he tried to eliminate Dutch Boy. Didn't quite make it. Oh, now what? Are you doing to the little guy?
He's just putting him to bed. That's all he's doing. It's bedtime.
Yeah, well, it's bedtime. I've never been put to bed like that.
Oh!
Dutch Boy Platinum has been eliminated.
He's gone.
Your next entrance is Rachel Arms. It's Juwan Thomas.
I don't think that was planned.
What did he do to Rachel Armstrong? Where is she?
He ate Rachel.
Oh, my God.
It's a kid. Matt Sterling has been eliminated.
Well, Brian, if fans on Facebook didn't get to see, this match is actually for the Gunslinger number one contendership.
Yes,
Brian.
It is. Yes, it is. Oh!
Little Tom Van Zandt has been eliminated.
The winner of this Halloween Battle Royal.
Hold on. No, we're not going to just skip over.
Your next entrance is Rachel Armstrong.
Juwan Thomas just picked up a little kid and threw him out of the ring. What the hell is wrong with him?
Well, we don't have time to explain that answer, Brian. There's a lot wrong with him.
But yes, this is for the Gunslinger Championship.
Number one contendership,
yes.
So, and this isn't going to be a normal traditional Halloween costume battle royal.
Right.
There is incentive.
We got steaks on the grill for this one.
Can I have the steaks tonight instead of going to that barbecue that Jackson Morgan's putting on?
What do you think we got the meat from?
Get him, Rachel!
Where's Kobe Jack? Is he okay?
It's the same meat that you got from the Tiger King.
Oh, no. I was out for days.
Hold on. Look, Juwan just taunting Rachel Armstrong here.
Juwan's never been...
Hey, to her credit, she don't back down from nobody.
Well, Juwan hasn't been in the ring with Rachel Armstrong yet, so he doesn't realize what Rachel can actually do.
He's seeing it now, and she's going right after the knee.
And Rachel Armstrong choking the life out of Juwan Thomas in the corner. I just killed the fly.
Hey, at least he finally died. I killed it last week.
Juwan is...
Your next entrant is Shorty P.
Shorty P not happy that the crowd wants Rachel to win this match. There's plenty of people still to come out.
And that's what I was referring to earlier when talking about people dressed up. We had Shorty P dressed up as a referee out there, and he went out quickly.
No. This is just Shorty P is going as retired Shorty P right now.
Juwan Thomas has been eliminated.
And Shorty's still in the ring.
And your next entrance is Timmy, a.k.a. Reggie.
He's not me, Nikki. He's not me. It's been 6 months. This is last October that started. It's been a year. It's been a freaking year.
These guys are going at it.
He is not. Get him out of here. Do not let him out there. He's an imposter.
How are you in two places at once?
Identity theft is not a joke, Brian.
They're chanting for Reggie. Let's listen to it.
What a face-off.
And Shorty P.
That hurts, Shorty. That hurts.
Poking Reggie
in the eye. Get out of my eyes, Shorty. Get out of my eyes.
How'd you like that job?
Rachel, help me. Help me, Rachel. Oh, you backstabbing little. This isn't fair. I'm in an extreme disadvantage in the ring right now, Brian.
It's not actually
the
game.
Get him, Rachel.
Tell him that.
Look, if he wants to pretend to be you, let him. It's not like your credit score's that good.
No, it's not. Still
your next entrant is Tyler Scott.
Who?
Who's Tyler Scott?
So we got a newcomer in the ring, Tyler Scott. Well, haven't seen him here before.
Tyler Scott actually has wrestled. He's been in tag team action here from time to time, not regularly, but he has been here.
Okay.
Mainly losing quickly to Utter Chaos and Ruthless Domination, but they have been here.
Well, everybody loses quickly to them, so that makes sense.
Yeah. I mean, Ruthless Domination tried to murder T.S. Wiley last week.
Yeah, nobody wanted to stop it either.
Nobody did.
I know.
That is the most offense we've seen from Jordy P all year.
That was a hell of a block. That was defense. Oh, Timmy going over, but no, not out yet.
Timmy's just trying to get him.
Oh, he's over. Well, yeah, Timmy's over.
Your next entrant is Flash.
Oh, and
Johnny Flash!
AKA, he is the Painmaker.
No, he's not. He's the Pain Taker. Brian, this match is about to pick up.
Tyler Scott has been eliminated.
I'll be honest, that is the most accurate costume I've seen tonight.
Retired Chris Jericho has made his way to the ring.
Yes, that's the most accurate costume I've seen. He's got the man bun.
Things are about to speed up out there right now with Johnny Flash in the ring. It is on. And lightning fast punches.
And Reggie taking it to Jericho there.
I'm not gonna have it.
Oh, and a chop.
I learned that the other day. Yeah.
The chop.
That's right.
You just messed it up. But showing that, you just did that wrong.
Well, I'm not good at it yet.
You know nobody can see. You could have just went, and it would have sounded like a chop.
There, boom.
He's not the official. He's not. Shorty P has been eliminated.
He is officially out.
Your next entrant is Logan Myers.
Oh, Jericho.
Give it up for your Ghostbuster, Logan Myers.
It is just a Ghostbuster jumpsuit. They do get in those quickly. Have you not seen the movies?
No.
You're useless.
I've not seen Ghostbusters.
You were a terrible American.
I'm sorry.
Johnny Flash has been eliminated.
Weapons are illegal, Logan Myers.
I don't think his weapon's working. Seems a little too soft for what it should be. And he just knocked Timmy to the... I think Timmy's knocked out.
No, that's just how he looks.
I mean, it looks like...
Your next entrant is Hammer.
It looks like he knows that when someone asks if you're a god, you always say yes. And we got Hammer from Ruthless Domination making his way.
It's Hammer time, Brian. It's Hammer time.
And these are guys that are like... They're in Halloween costume 52 weeks a year.
Are they, though?
Yes. I mean, normal people don't walk around with their faces.
Oh, true.
Yeah, true. Well,
come on, Rachel.
Makeup, yeah.
Good point. Hammer, stay away from me.
Well, you don't want a makeup tutorial from Hammer?
No.
And they said Timmy. Max Sterling's still out there coaching.
Your next entrant is Scorpion.
Oh, well, now we got both members of Ruthless Domination.
Ooh, what if this comes down to Hammer and Scorpion?
You know, they'll have to fight each other. We saw that at Fight or Die between the highlight reel with the Young Guns tournament.
Scorpion looks like he's been through some stuff tonight.
Scorpion looks like he has the same makeup artist as Jax. And they just go right after Logan Myers. Like, hey, we're just going to do this to you.
Scorpion's, he looks like he just got out of a fight with Arn Anderson backstage.
No, he would have a hole in his head.
Clock Anderson, Clock Anderson, baby.
And
Logan Myers has been eliminated. And your next entrant is Hillbilly Jed. A.K.A. Mario.
Hold on, what? Oh, it's Super Mario! Super Mario!
What does he have?
He's got a power
are
up.
Are foreign objects legal?
Rachel Armstrong has been eliminated.
Look at the power ups. And he's got the raccoon. I want to see him fly, though. Can he fly?
Well, he is Raccoon Mario right now.
Right. When he's got that tail, he can fly.
That means he has to go to the top rope, Brian.
I know. We better see it.
I'm for it.
Oh, no, don't do this. No, no, you're going to kill him.
No,
you're
going to
kill him. Oh! I don't think we can show that live on Facebook.
Your next entrant is Kobe Jack, a.k.a. Jason Muhees.
Who?
Jason Muhees?
Jason Muhees. Hold on. That guy's got mad
cow. That's the most terrifying cow I've ever seen, Brian.
That's a mad cow.
I am terrified.
This ain't horny. What?
Moo, moo, moo.
I know.
Moo, moo. Moo, moo. Oh, that's got to start to hurt.
Your next entrant is Cesar Cerveza, a.k.a. The Great Muda.
Is it great, though?
I mean, it's the below average Muda.
It's the
Cesar Cerveza, who we've seen here the past couple weeks. Not victoriously, but hey, he could win this and jump right at the top of the Gunslinger title picture. And you see Hammer and Scorpion just going to town on Muda. Oh, and the cow going after Scorpion or Hammer.
Brian, this match has deteriorated quickly. There's no order left.
It's about to run.
Everybody's out for themselves.
Your next entrance is the birthday boy, Pogo, a.k.a. Savage Terry.
Savage Terry?
Yeah.
What?
Pogo.
Oh, my God.
It's his birthday today, too. Sammy Terry tribute.
Brian, keep me away from that because I'm afraid of spiders.
It's a fake spider.
That looks very real.
No, it's fake.
It's scary. Okay. It's terrifying. Any of these men would be viable options as number one contender for the Gunslinger Championship.
I wouldn't go that far.
Three quarters of the people in this ring, a few of these people in the ring would be great, great number one. Two of them would be great number one contenders. Oh my God, that's not Sammy Terry, that's Pogo.
Yes. That's
Your next entrant is Brody Bodkins.
Brody Bodkins, what? We saw him here last week against Jed. What a hell of a
great
match.
Great, really good match.
Yes.
He made an impact.
Who is that in the coffin back there? I just know that thing's coming to life. Who is that back there? And who is this guy walking out with Brody Bodkins?
And where did he get a championship belt? What belt is that?
No idea.
Can this just be for his belt? Can we just have this match be for that belt?
No, because it is not a WCWO sanctioned title.
Blake defended our belt against TJP in a non-WCW show.
No, but that was sanctioned for WCWO.
That's true. That's true. Yes. That's true. That's true.
Pogo going after Jed. We've seen that time and time again over the years. Two staples here at the Dub. Almost its entirety of existence, like 30 years.
Very familiar with each other. They both know each other's strengths and weaknesses.
Your next entrant is Luigi.
What?
Oh, we got a Mario. What? Who's Luigi?
Are we going to get Wario?
I hope not. Nobody likes Mario. Brody Bodkins is taking it to Timmy in the corner there. Flatten Timmy a bit. That doesn't look like Luigi.
Luigi looks different. Is he supposed to be wearing green?
And the cow just knocked the face right off the skull. I don't know who that is. He called himself Luigi, though. He don't look Italian. He don't have lasagna in his hand.
Ooh, lasagna sounds good. You mean deep dish pizza?
No, that's noodle lasagna.
Oh, okay.
And you see the cow, can he hang on? The cow hung on, saved himself from elimination.
Right, Timmy.
Your next entrant is Damon Jackson.
Who's Damon Jackson? Okay.
And again, we never know who's going to pop up. New guys we've never seen before, maybe some old faces.
Cecil Cerveza has been eliminated. And your next entrant is Professor T.S. Wiley. AKA The Punisher. Your next entrant is Jackson Morgan.
Halloween.
Yeah, but my beard ain't that damn gray.
30 years ago, Pete. Pete Younger. Jackson Morgan looks different.
Jackson Morgan walking out there like he got beat up earlier.
Retired.
Oh, no, new Skull Crusher.
Retired Jackson.
I see Skull Crusher out there.
He's dressed as Jackson Morgan.
No, there's Skull Crusher in the ring right there.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. You're right.
Yeah. Hold on.
Brian, I'm so confused right now.
Oh, Jed running through.
Your next entrant is Pennywise.
Hold on. What? I didn't see
can
99
we do
red that? Balloons.
Is he going to float?
We
is
all
everyone,
float.
Is everyone floating in there?
We all float.
No, I'm.
Oh, no, that's not Pennywise. It's Penny Myers. It's Michael Weiss. He's German. Michael Weiss. I don't know. Which is better? Let us know. Penny Myers or Michael Weiss?
Scorpion and Hammer have been eliminated.
Whoa, I didn't see that one. I was distracted by Michael Weiss.
This match is out of control, Brian. I don't even know who's going to win this. Anything is possible at this point.
Yeah. But hey, that's the fun of this match. That's the fun of the evening. This is why the fans, it's one of their favorites to come to. You know, our Halloween shows are always just something fun, something special. You never know what you're going to see.
And now the Battle Royal for something big, number one contendership for a championship. That's how we do it here at the Dub now. It's like a Halloween MLB All-Star game. It's for something. It means something now.
Yeah, but nobody likes it. That's why they got rid of that.
Did they?
Yes.
Punisher has been eliminated.
Hey, I'm not watching the World Series because the Astros are. I don't like cheaters.
Have they already been?
If that's the case, I would cheer for Jordan James.
Yes. Haven't they already accused the Astros of doing something?
Rolling Thunder to Brody Bodkins by Jed. That's twice in 2 weeks he has felt that. There's just so much happening in the ring. This is just the best camera angle to capture it all.
Oh, the real Jackson Morgan has come out.
Your next Jackson Morgan?
This doesn't bode well for Jackson Morgan.
There's two Jackson Morgans? What?
This is like Doink, but terrifying.
Hold on, clowns are terrifying.
We've got one in the ring already, kind of.
No, you got
Michaels.
He's not a clown.
Jackson Morgan is going at it with Jackson Morgan. Jackson Morgan with the headbutt to Jackson
that
Morgan.
That sounds like one of your Saturday nights.
Jackson Morgan is out of control, beating the hell out of Jackson Morgan.
Awesome.
I'm saying it. Brody Bodkins whipped with the clothesline to the
That's animal abuse. PETA better not be watching this show.
Yeah, PETA. Nobody cares about PETA. Unless it's an actual PETA. Those are delicious.
Yeah. I haven't had PETA pit in a while. Is that still around?
I don't know. You would, Wyatt.
No, that's gone. That's an AT&T store now.
Oh, then I'd say no. That was the last one. No,
it's a Lou Malnati's now.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Somehow we always talk about food.
Yeah.
As if, like, we didn't eat beforehand.
Oh, we did.
Actually, I did. And a potato.
Yes.
Yes.
And an Italian sandwich on the street. Brody Bodkins is eliminated. Mario is eliminated. Brody Bodkins. Oh, that thunderous chop from Jackson Morgan to the chest of Timmy. Good God.
Brody Bodkins has been eliminated.
Pogo was working over Kenny Myers.
Penny Weiss.
Michael Weiss. Or
Michael Weiss. That's right. Michael Weiss.
Yes.
Oh, no. Well, there he is.
Penny Weiss. Myers has been eliminated.
Yes.
Oh, my God. That's not really Jackson Morgan. That's Skull Crusher.
Oh, what a dropkick. But, yeah, he just demasked. Jackson Morgan just took his own face off, revealed that it was actually Skull Crusher. Oh, and there goes Skull Crusher. Slash Jackson Morgan.
Slash loser of a street fight.
Yes.
A fast loss.
Losers of the tag titles.
A quick loss.
He's single-handed.
We have one more entrance.
You leaked once, you lost.
Hold on, there's one more
entrance. Carnage!
Carnage? What?
Who? Hold on. We can get sued for this.
Hold on. That's not. Hold on. Brian, I know who this is. I'll be right back.
Okay. I was just wondering if I could show this or if Marvel's going to sue us or Sony.
Jackson Morgan has been eliminated. Both of them. Whoa. Jason Levi, you don't work here anymore. You quit 3 weeks ago. You don't work here anymore. Get out of the ring. You don't work. You can't become the Gunslinger number one contender. You quit. You don't work here anymore. Get out of the ring.
Oh, and Jason Levi.
Jason Levi has been eliminated.
I mean, I don't know how you can be eliminated if you're not actually employed here or contracted here. He did quit. Not sure why he thought he could enter, but he did.
Reggie!
Oh, and Jackson's got Reggie. Oh, man, commentary may be better if Jackson actually kills him tonight. And I lost
Damon Jackson has been eliminated.
Hey, I lost the HD point. Unplug that cord and plug it back in. Oh, never mind. It's good.
Yeah!
Hey, they got Reggie. No one's going to help him.
Do it!
No one's going to help him. and Jed with a shot to the gut. Oh! What a forearm to the back. Reggie can come back to commentary after this. Oh, and he got
Reggie
there,
has
though.
Been eliminated.
He got out of there. He wasn't getting beat up by Jed anymore. I don't think he expected to run into Jackson Morgan. And now they're trying to get Timmy out. Well, at least Colby Jack is. Jack, no, he's still hanging on.
Get Timmy out.
Get Timmy out.
All right. All the commotion going on out there. Mobile cam cut out on me. Trying to get that fixed. Reggie's on his way back.
This Battle Royal's got everything. We got Mario, Timmy, Pogo, Colby Jack in the ring. Anything is possible. And only these four men have been in the ring. Nobody else has been out there. It's insane. My back is a little sore. I slept on it wrong. Jed has been eliminated.
Mario has been eliminated.
Well, hopefully this man doesn't win the number one contendership, because we can't live with ourselves if Timmy is the number one contender for the Gunslinger title. We can't. Smash has everything, guys. Everything. And Timmy, that horrible, horrible person going to work on Pogo's head, the surgically repaired neck of Pogo. This lunatic is trying to injure everybody in the ring. What a horrible person this Timmy is. I didn't know about that, Brian.
I know.
All that happens is I go out there to get Jason Levi out of the ring.
Hey.
And the next thing I know, Jackson Morgan, that lunatic, sadistic person, grabs me and throws me into the ring in a match I'm not booked in. I hadn't signed a contract to be in that match.
Hey, anybody out there, though, could have been in it, and you were out there, so it counts. And you got beat up by Super Mario, which is funny. Up, Timmy going up, over. Is he done? These guys have been trying to eliminate each other throughout the entirety of this match. I think they've been in there the longest. Either one giving up.
And I can say, any of these two men out there would be viable options for another one contender.
Cal just taking horns over and over and over to Pogo there. Pogo laying there lifeless.
Brian, I had to step out. I had to step out for a second. Has anyone eliminated Timmy yet? Because that man should not be the number. Why is he still
in? Hold on. Kobe Jack on the edge. Step back off the ledge, my friend. You want to finish that lyric?
We could cut ties with all the lies that they've been living in, Brian.
There we go.
I had to think for a second. The last time I heard that song, we couldn't see the band on stage.
We did. Yeah,
we did.
That's true.
We did.
Yeah.
Could not see them.
We shot some great silhouettes in.
We did. Kind of like the Shinedown show, silhouettes.
Hey, I got some great shots.
I did. That was a great show.
Yeah. All I heard was somebody yell, "Get off." Hold on, who's going over here? They're forcing each other.
Kobe
Jack has been eliminated.
Timmy being number one contender, this is unbelievable.
That is awesome.
This is unacceptable, Brian.
Dude, it's Timmy or Pogo, either one of these guys. We can only hope that it's Pogo. To the Gunslinger title. This is awesome.
It's either going to be the legendary, iconic WCW mainstay Pogo, or Tim. A man that doesn't even know who he is. He thinks he's me.
He knows he's you.
He
knows he's Reggie. Off the rope. Timmy with another shoulder block. Or shoulder tackle, sorry. Going for another Pogo, barely able to stand.
Another Timmy tackle.
Yes, Timmy tackle. Going for the bear. He's getting power from that bear. I think we're going to have Timmy as the number one contender.
No. Don't say that. Don't say that, Brian.
I am putting that into existence.
No. Do you take that back?
No.
Take that back.
No, hold on. What is Dalton Davis doing out there? He's going to toss Timmy over. What the hell?
Timmy has been eliminated?
I'm torn on how to feel about this right now.
Oh,
wow! Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
The bear is dead! He killed the bear!
Those bastards!
And now Pogo taking it out.
Why is Dalton Davis out there? This is for the number one contendership to his title. Why is he inserting himself into this match?
If he wins, then there is no number one contender for his title.
He can't be his own number one contender.
Yes, you can. You can be your own worst enemy.
That's his entrance theme.
I know. Oh, Pogo. What a savage Pogo. I'm still shocked. We just witnessed a murder. Literally, he just killed that bear.
Oh, your winner and number one contender for the Gunslinger title, Pogo!
Brian, the gasps from the crowd.
Give it up for your number one contender, Pogo!
Hey, look, he was out there trying to stop it. If he would have won, he wouldn't have had a number one contender for his title. That is a brilliant move.
Dalton is not happy right now.
That's like getting the first round bye or something, or a bye right to the championship in the tournament. It's a great move.
Now here's the question. When does Pogo get that championship match? He's the new number one contender. What does this mean for JB?
Give it up again. The number one contender for the Gunslinger title. Pogo!
What does this mean for JB? He didn't lose that match fair and square. He still has a stake. But now Pogo is the number one contender for the title. What happens?
Hey, that's just something management's going to sort out. But hey, look, how many times have we seen a wrestler cheat to win? He had his opportunity. Dalton Davis spoiled that opportunity by any means necessary. Again, ref didn't see what happened. That was that.
Where do we go from here?
I don't know.
Well,
I don't know.
Well, it doesn't stop here, Brian, because what's next?
But, well, we can ask him.
I bet you want the inside scoop, huh? I bet you want to know why I went out there, huh?
Can we get some help out here to pick up all the insides of that teddy bear?
It's simple.
Please.
If I were to have won that match like I should have, I would have been the number one contender, and there would have been nobody that could touch me as Gunslinger champion. But you know what? I'm glad Pogo had his little Cinderella moment. I'm so happy because, truthfully, from the bottom of my heart, if there's anybody in here that deserves to have a title match, it is Pogo. But don't get it misconcepted. You see, Pogo is just going to be another day in the park. I'm going to go out there and I'm going to do what I do best, and that is retain the WCWO Gunslinger Championship.
First off, why did you kill the bear? Why did you commit murder in the... Teddy did nothing to you, Dalton. Nothing. He was just an innocent, but it wasn't even in the match.
That match.
Who's ready for your next matchup?
For my title. And I'm not going to let a little boy or some stupid ass little...
We already got Tommy Two Shoes in the ring.
Be in that
match. Getting rid of the bear.
You want to make a mockery of what I built, Reggie? Then go ahead.
Introducing first.
And if you keep on talking, yours will be next. Now, I'm going to go. I'm going to knock a couple cold ones back. And you guys have fun doing your little nerd stuff, huh?
I hope he means lemonades. He's not. I hope he means lemonades. I don't know that he's old enough to drink, Brian. Dalton.
So, yeah. At least he came and explained it. We don't have to wonder. But
Teddy's innards are outside the ring right now, Brian. Are we going to just ignore the fact that there are bear guts ringside on the floor?
Hey, we got to clean up a mess. It happens. But speaking of cleaning up messes.
Heartbroken.
Outlaw title on the line now. It is happening now. Jordan James challenging Dex Royal for the Outlaw Championship. These guys used to be thick as thieves up until a couple weeks ago. And then we saw Jordan turn on him. We saw Jordan lure after lying to Dex since Dex won the championship about how proud he was of him and how he wasn't jealous. We saw him lure Dex into a trap with EZ Cruz, Max Sterling. A big brawl broke out back. That's showing, look, it was official then, I guess. Couldn't have been more official without a whistle. That Dex in highlight reel no longer a part of the mafia. He has his own new mafia, and he's ready.
Last night, Jordan James said he was on the cusp of a historic night for himself and had a chance to become a double champion.
Well,
that
so
has
far,
not, that
yeah.
has not aged well.
No, it did not.
Didn't age well.
Now we're just awaiting the Outlaw champion himself, Dex Royal. Hold on, this is some different music. I'm just going to play. Let's see if we get in trouble.
This is scary. This is ominous. This is haunting. This is dark.
Well, this is also a classic. I mean, I wouldn't bet $5 on this match. Honestly, it's a toss-up to me. Because who knows Dex better than Jordan? I don't think anybody does.
Dex is here, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, there he is.
Well, I mean, he's here. He hasn't shown up on the stage yet.
No? Okay.
No. I mean, look, there's the shot. Do you see him? Oh, he is there. Dex Royal is on the... He is here.
Brian, that's not Dex Royal.
No, that is Genesis. That is... the inner alter ego that he taps into when he needs to.
This is the darkest
This is the darkest,
sinister side of Dex Royale's personality.
This is the darkest timeline. This is the darkest variant of Dex Royale. This is Genesis.
If fans aren't familiar with that, you could compare it to what Finn Balor would do channeling the demon. He brings that out when he has to bring him out, when he has to channel, like you said, the darkest variant of himself.
Yes.
This is Dex, but this is not Dex.
Make sure to follow him. Follow him close. Dex is prepared, man.
Dex is ready. He is not going to let anything get in the way of him in retaining his Outlaw Championship. He worked his ass off for years to get to this point, and he is not going to let a scumbag like Jordan James steal that title from him.
I agree. And he was different all week. And that crowd giving him an ovation. You know, I really don't know what to make of this. I mean, I think I've only seen the Genesis come out of Dex Royale one time.
It was, and it was when he was trying to get that territorial title from Jackson Morgan.
Yes. Well, let's go to Nikki for the ring announcements. Outlaw title on the line here.
Introducing first, he is Jordan. Danger is my middle name, James. His opponent is your WCWO Outlaw Champion. He is Genesis.
Yeah. Well, Brian, we just mentioned that the last time we saw Genesis was when Dex Royale was trying to defeat Jackson Morgan. He did that solely because he felt the only way he could conquer the monster Jackson Morgan was to bring out his own monster.
To beat a monster, you gotta be a monster. And you know what? He felt the same way here with Jordan James.
Different kind of monster.
Jordan James is a monster. There's no doubt about it.
Yes.
He is diabolical. He is ruthless. And he doesn't care about your feelings. He only cares about himself and what he wants.
But you can see the fear in the eyes of Jordan James right now.
I don't think that's fear. That's confusion.
No, that's terrible.
He wasn't ready to face Genesis. He thought he was facing Dex. So he knows what he's in for now. But in his mind, he's calculating how you go about taking on
cautiously
this darkest version of Dex Royale.
Cautiously getting back into the ring. Because he has to change his entire game plan, his entire strategy now.
Yes.
He's prepared for the golden spotlight, not for Genesis.
Right. And folks, feel free to comment on what you've liked, what you've seen. Who was your favorite costume in the Battle Royal?
Apparently my costume is somebody in a Battle Royal.
You're always wearing a costume.
That's true.
When you're that ugly, yeah.
That's true.
All right, tilt that camera up.
Both men circling each other, feeling each other out, taking their time getting to that first lockup and that first offensive move.
Like, the tension is just so palpable. The crowd doesn't know how to be reacting right now.
Jordan James doesn't know what to do.
Did somebody dress up as Skull Crusher? Is that who's sitting next to Rob Pugh?
To dress up.
Yeah. Oh!
And Dex Royale, Genesis throwing Jordan James down with authority. We don't often see Jordan James reeling and retreating like this.
Yeah, we do.
Not like this.
Yeah, we do.
This is.
He's always retreating.
But not like this.
Remember, he wasn't here last week when he knew.
You have to show up to retreat.
Yeah, he retreated the week before.
I don't remember.
And he didn't come back.
I don't remember the. Oh.
That's remember right. when Blake Wright ran the damn show?
That's right. Yes.
Yeah, he was here because he knew Dex Royal and the highlight reel were not in the building that week. And then last week when they were, guess who wasn't here? Get down there and follow him. All right, yeah, that's me calling to the cameraman. Trying to give you the best angles here. Some of the crowd. Oh, missed. Oh!
No more little Jordans for him.
Big Pete. No more grandkids.
Big Pete, by the way, hope you're doing okay. Big Pete, he couldn't stomach the idea of his own son becoming Outlaw Champion. He could even be here to possibly see that happen.
Is that why he's not here?
That's why he's not here. Actually, I'm not sure why he's not here, but it sounded good.
Oh, Jordan goes for the punch, but missed. Oh, whoa! T-bone suplex from the crowd back in to the area of play, I guess you could call it. Just over the guardrail. And back in the ring. Dex Rowe don't want to win due to count out. There's no gimmicks in this match. It is just a straight up title match.
Oh, powerful forearm.
Ten count still applies. Yeah. Oh, and a cut. What would you call that?
That
like the reverse cutter? Like
that was just an elbow to the chest of Dex Royal. That's all that was.
Oh, and another low clothesline with the elbow there. Crowd saying he messed up. I don't see how he messed up. Genesis is down.
It's a little early in the match to be ripping off the rock.
Oh. Now you've messed up. Now you've messed up.
You have messed up now. Oh, he's awakened the demon in Dex Royal Genesis. He is laying it in hard.
Oh! That one connected all the way. Dex is down.
That took his face off.
Dex is down. One. No. Just a one count. Man, there was a lot behind that spinning heel kick by Jordan James.
All that did was make Dex Royal focus even more, though. You saw the look in his eyes there. Dex is in a different kind of zone tonight.
What are you doing with it? You can't be using this. He was choking you, baby. You know you're doing this. All right, just go ahead and get back on the other side. Look at the scowl on Dex's face, or Genesis, whatever you want to call him tonight. It's almost like he's imitating Jordan James, who permanently has that scowl. I'm sure his mom told him, you know, if you keep making a face, it'll stick like that. That's what happened.
Sounds about right.
Up, caught him. Rolls him over after the powerbomb and a boot to the face. That's how he kicked the trash down the driveway. Oh, and from nothing, just picked him up into the suplex. One, two, three. No, two count. That is impressive, though. Like, Dex Royal isn't known for his strength, but Jordan was down and out and literally just picked him from the mat into the suplex, back down to the mat. And now, Dex, a.k.a. Genesis tonight, going up top. Oh.
Pure desperation from Jordan James. Pure desperation.
Yes. My phone's vibrating. Why?
Oh, and chopped in the chest of Dudley Royal. Jordan James just trying to do anything he can to get back in this match. Oh, a DDT off the top rope. The tides have turned in this match.
Yes.
That DDT off the top rope really kind of changed.
The turntables.
That's right.
Watch it, watch it, guys.
He just put his whole body into that one. Not a shoulder, not an elbow. Whole body, hip, everything. Caught him with a right hand elbow. Couldn't really tell. Whips him into the corner. But Dex uses that momentum, that anger, coming back on Jordan James. Yes, Bruce, we agree. Oh, what a cross body. Oh, and a springboard flatliner going for the pin. One, two, and three. Alright, I'm tired of doing that.
Dex Royal just sizing up his prey. They will not die.
Yeah, it's not like Ruthless Domination was a few weeks ago where they were playing with their food when they had Professor Wiley in the ring. He's not playing around.
Neither entrees would taste good.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, plus which totally when it meets that fatty like Wiley. Oh, what a shot!
Well, what a skunk, what is possible? I mean,
yeah. What a shot. Dex Royal going up high.
Oh, flying Air Canada.
One, two, three.
It's over, Brian.
Winner, and still your Outlaw champion, Genesis.
Dex Royal tapping into his inner darkest side, the variant Genesis.
Give it up for your winner, and still your Outlaw champion, Genesis.
Remains the Outlaw champion. Thankfully, we are saved from having to deal with the ego that would have been Jordan James had he become champion. Giving an ovation for Dex Royal retaining his championship, the Outlaw Championship, against Jordan James. And he had one hell of a
give it up again for your winner, and still your Outlaw Champion, Genesis!
Wow. Well, no. Second. His last one, he did defend it against Vinny, and we haven't seen Vinny Vincenzo back since.
This is true.
And Jordan just laying there in his own puddle of disappointment and failure. If he was to have his own fragrance, that's what it would be called. I cracked myself up. Waka waka.
No friends.
And look, he went around. He tried to skirt around the rules. He tried to get the match approved by Blake. He didn't want to straight up challenge for the title, but Dex Royal last week came out and said, look, I don't care. You can have your match.
Yeah.
And he proved why. Dex knew what he was tapping into.
His fans letting him have it, Brian.
I agree with the fans. All right.
Well, this match originally
main event, guys.
Originally was going to be in the parking lot, but due to the weather, Brian, not
all right.
That.
Good.
While we're setting up for the main event, I need first all of the kids in costume to please form a line and come on up here in the ring with me. So all the kids in the costumes, please come up here to the ring. We're going to do the kids first and then the adults costume contest.
So, yeah, we are setting up for two things at once. Multitasking here. But yeah, like you were saying, go ahead.
This match originally going slated to be in the parking lot, but due to the rain, due to the weather, and the cold temperatures outside, this match will now be a car parts, junkyard car parts match inside the ring.
Yes.
In the arena, which honestly, just as dangerous, just as violent, just as grueling, just in a different way.
And look, we can see there's hoods. Grills. Yes. We're seeing grills and not the Paul Wall kind.
Oh.
Ah, I got that night a 2000s reference in there. But yes, so let's just recap the story here.
Yeah, when did this originally really start, Brian? It's been
just
about
over a month ago.
Yeah.
You know, after Dex beat Blake, Blake went on a little hiatus, but when he came back, he was targeting the owner of WCWO. He was blaming him
for his loss.
Originally,
he was blamed. He put heat on the fans and blamed the fans for turning on him.
Yeah.
Then Joey came out to just try to calm Blake down and talk some sense into him.
Right. And that's when he turned to blame the owner of WCWO. You know who? He's been doing this for a year now on his own.
Yeah.
Took advantage and started attacking him.
Verbally and physically.
Yes. And then that culminated into what? 2 weeks ago.
Well, he verbally attacked not just Joey, but Joey's family.
Yes.
And then assaulted Joey in the ring. And then that turned into Blake Money feuding with Jason Levi for a few weeks, because Jason Levi wanted to come to the defense and stand up for Joey Owens. So
yes.
Joey didn't have to get in the ring. Levi took it upon himself to really fight that battle for Joey, but Blake did what he said he was going to do, push Levi out of the company.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And then as Levi attacked Joey back out in the parking lot after the show for getting involved in the match between him and Blake Wright, while Joey is down, Blake came showed up.
Yes.
And finished him off.
Right, that was in the parking lot.
Yeah.
Completely took Joey out of action to the point where the week that Blake took over, Joey was not able to be here. He was ordered by his doctors to stay home.
Which is why Blake
took
rest. That's why Blake hijacked the show.
Exactly. Completely hijacked everything. But then they laid it out there last week when Joey came back. When, you know, the chairman, he's the chairman for a reason. Came back, used that chair.
And the hood of Blake's car.
Was that Blake's car
we figured it out? Did you not hear it when Joey came out with the hood? Blake said, "That's the hood of my car."
No, I did not hear that.
He did.
Because we thought it was my hood.
Blake had to buy a new car.
Good.
Good.
He's Blake Less Money right now.
He's Blake Financed, right?
Yeah. He's Blake Least.
Yes. But, yeah, and then that's when it was put on. The line, the ownership of the company was put up for grabs there.
And that took everybody off guard because you and I, Brian, sat in the room with Joey to try to talk him out of getting involved.
Right, yeah. Look,
he said,
that
Joey,
was,
don't do that.
That was a conversation we had Sunday, or, you know, Friday night after the show, Saturday during the day, Sunday during training,
it's like
Monday during creative.
It's like a bully. If you don't acknowledge him, he'll eventually just stop, hopefully.
Right, yeah.
But,
Joey's
old school kid pride.
He was hell-bent on, like, look, he thinks this is his show. Let's put his money where his mouth is. Let's see if it really is his show. You know? Look, who knows what could happen?
Listen, Blake.
Obviously, you and I are not rooting for
Blake's been
for
walking
Joey.
Around here.
I mean, for Blake.
Blake's been walking around here all night telling people what he's going to do to us if he wins.
Yes.
It's scary.
Yeah. Well, he hasn't said anything to me, but.
I can't repeat what he said he's going to do.
He hasn't said anything to me.
Really?
Yeah.
I've been here a lot longer than you have today. And
yeah, exactly. He hasn't said nothing to me.
Yeah.
But then again, he don't know what I do. He doesn't know any of this. Trust me, we've filmed with him. I know this, that he doesn't know.
True.
Yeah. So, as of right now, we are doing the costume contest right now. Didn't want to show that. You know, some people may not want their kids put on social media.
Correct.
So, we are setting up for that right now and doing that. Although, there were some adorable costumes. This is just something you had to be here for tonight to see. It's one of the perks of actually coming to the show. But also, tomorrow night, depending on the weather, it'll be in the parking lot across from the WCWO, or it'll actually be in the building. Mm-hmm. Bring your kids. Hell, bring some pets. I mean, there's pets all throughout this building right now. Come on out. We got, trick-or-treating, trunk-or-treating, whatever you want to call it, from 6 to 8. Reggie just motioned. He's got to go pee-pee. Yep. Yeah, so... Yeah, so we do have that from 6 to 8 tomorrow night. Come to the dub. Some of the wrestlers will be here. People will be dressed up. Come have some fun. Pass out candy. Who knows what kind of tricks we may play. It'll be a lot of fun, though. But what is not fun, what is very serious, is what we're about to deal with here. The main event for Freaky Friday. This could be the last WCWO Presents show. Hopefully it's not. But it looks like we're ready, so let's go to the ring. Just waiting for the music to be played. Obviously, due to some copyright issues, can't play it. Again, I want to give props to those who decorated tonight. They did a hell of a job. The building looks awesome. What do you guys think here on Facebook? How's the building look? You right there, Tom? You want to get on the headset?
Sure, why
not? So one of the rare cases we're going to be able to hear from a referee during this match. Legendary ref Tommy Two Shoes. You're personal friends with Kid.
Well, really, to be quite honest, you really don't need a ref for this. I mean, it's pretty much a street fight.
Yes. Hey, somebody's got to be there to count three, or stop the match when they quit.
Right.
You know. But I know we were just talking about how Reggie and I all week have been trying to talk Kid out of putting the ownership of the company on the line. You're one of his best friends. For what, 20 plus years?
Yeah.
I'm sure you've had conversations.
Yeah, this last week's been kind of stressful. We talked about a lot of things. We did talk about what if he did lose.
Right. Yeah, this could be one of the last ever WCWO Presents shows. You know, who knows what it would turn. Oh, we got some fog here. But who knows what it could be next week if he loses. Like, there's a lot up at stake here.
Yeah, a lot of it at stake.
You know? But he seems ready.
Yeah.
No doubt about that.
Yeah, he was back here doing about 100 squats about an hour ago, warming up. And he got the weights out, did a little weight training. He's definitely ready for this match.
All right, I'm going to risk getting shut off Facebook. Crowd chanting, JKO wanted you guys to hear that, even though there's copyrighted music playing. Seems what happened. If they kick us off, I'll just start a new Facebook Live and
yeah.
You'll rejoin us.
Yeah.
Let's go to Nikki for the announcements.
Sing first. He is from Fishers, Indiana. He is the overall number one draft pick, Blake Money Wright. And his opponent is from Indianapolis, Indiana. He is the chairman, JKO.
All right.
Well, you know who's got my
Yeah. Look, normally we want to remain unbiased. There's quite a few matches tonight. I did not remain unbiased. Don't care. I don't like Jordan James. I'm always going to say that. And especially after what we saw 2 weeks ago. You were here. You were reffing those matches,
yeah,
what we saw 2 weeks
ago.
Nobody wants that.
It was definitely a surprise.
He literally made the entire show about him.
Yeah, it did. It was pretty stressful. I didn't know who he was going to stay, who he was going to let go. I know he had a list.
He immediately fired Nikki right off the bat. Yeah. Started the show up. And made himself the ring announcer. He took over our social medias and put every douchey-looking picture he's ever taken. Yeah. All over our social media. Yeah, if that's what we can expect, then I'm definitely rooting for Joey here. Kind of a stalemate. Right, now they're just trading shots. Measuring each other up here.
I don't think Blake wants to do this. That's
no.
Joey, that's a real fire.
Oh!
Yeah,
there it was. He felt that one. Joey laid him out there, still talking trash.
I don't think he is done playing with him.
No, but that could cost him. Look,
yeah,
we know what Blake's capable of.
Yes, we can come and bite him on the butt.
Yeah. They're just trading blows back and forth. Oh,
chop.
Felt that one. Oh, hey. That wasn't good enough. Free shot. Oh, he's the master of the chop. You sure you want to go at him like this?
Once again, Blake don't want to do this. That's just my card. kid up.
And look, that last chop sent Blake to the outside. Chopping the hell out of each other. Forearm smashes to their faces.
Yeah, right now they're over there by all the toys that we've sent out there.
Yes. Oh! Hey, guys, go ahead and get down there. Get down there. Get down there. Right. Trying to get the cameraman down there. Kept loose. It does.
All right, kids, get some toys in the ring.
Well, Tommy, I was just out there, and it's electric out there. It's just pure mayhem. These two men obviously have a lot to fight for here.
Yeah.
Joey it's not just him fighting to keep the company under his control. He's fighting for his legacy and his family's legacy and his father's legacy.
Yeah, sure.
Which you've been here for almost all of that.
Yes.
And so I know you have a little bit of a stake in this as well. And
yeah.
Blake Money Wright doesn't care about any of that. He just cares about himself. He sees the control, and that's all he is. He's power hungry. He saw that a few weeks ago. And if that is anything like if that was, I don't even want to be here for any of that. It's going to take a lot more than that to beat Joey Owens for control of the company that his dad created. It's going to take a lot. You're going to have to almost kill him to win this match.
I'm not surprised Blake went for the pin. It's too early.
Well, the more pins he goes for, the more he makes Joey kick out, the more tired he's going to make Joey. But he's going to have to take it to another level to win this match. It's not going to be as easy and simple as a couple little moves and then a couple pins. You're going to have to, like I said, basically kill the guy to win this match. Joey's got Blake up against that car hood. Tommy, after Joey took the hood off of Blake's last car, Blake had to go out and get a new car. He got a black truck, and that's a black hood.
Yeah.
And it's a lot more heavy-duty hood than the one that there was. Blake might have to get a second car.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, I see that poor grill out there that came off the truck.
I think Joey dismantled Blake's new truck. No, somebody on the interstate dismantled your van. I don't like what this is looking. I don't like how this is looking right now.
I don't like this at all.
That's not what I thought he was going to do with that, but still not good. Uh-oh.
Get out of the kitchen, Juanita. You're going to want to see this.
Oh,
don't bring her into this.
No,
uh-oh.
He did not.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Oh,
oh no!
No,
no, no.
Oh,
no.
Get
A
stand for that. No, he's not.
Oh, there you go. And Blake might want to check any food he gets from that concession stand for a while.
Yeah.
Because Juanita will poison his dinner tomorrow. Yeah, Blake better not take that free hot dog when the show's over. Good point.
All right, kids, you step it up or not.
I know Jackson Morgan killed a guy earlier this week, but we could see a second third if you count Teddy.
Yeah.
Whose innards are now underneath that ring. Blake's running away from Joey after this comment about Juanita. Both men are brawling outside the ring. They're next to the bathroom and the stairs. Going up the stairs. This could be dangerous, Tommy. This isn't looking good for either man.
Yeah.
One wrong move, one wrong step. It's not well lit back there.
No, it's not.
He just pushed Blake off of the steps. Well, we knew going on that this wasn't going to be a wrestling match. It was going to be the most violent show that we've seen in a long time. It's going to be a fight almost to the death. And look at Blake just retreating like the just piece of scum that he is. That doesn't sound good for one of these two. Like just choking the life out of Joey Owens, what's left of Joey Owens at this point.
Yeah.
I'm not liking where this is going. It's not looking. Blake has no business experience whatsoever. He didn't major in it at Anderson University. He doesn't know the first thing about running a company. I don't even think he's filed taxes, like, ever. So. Months ago, Blake Money Wright was reaching for the fans to put him where he is at WCWO, and now, just 7-8 months later, nobody's reaching back for him.
Uh-oh.
Going for a second driver. Blake gets out of it, kicked in the chest. He's got him.
Oh!
That didn't just happen. No.
Oh, no.
Money Wright.
No.
No.
You've got to be kidding me.
Well, Reggie,
are you ready to retire again, Tommy?
I don't know. God,
that didn't just happen. This. I don't even know what to say right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Blake Money Ryan has just won control of WCWO. And,
Blake Money Ryan!
All right, I am, gonna go check over here.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to fade out. Thanks for tuning in. We will see you next week, we hope.